Hello there, welcome to my channel. Today I am going to present to you the darker side of YouTube that clearly needs to be addressed. Meet Cory. Cory suffers from cerebral palsy. He uses a voice simulator to assist him with his speech. Ah, there you are. What's so special about Cory is, despite his disabilities, being a victim of abuse and sadly losing his mother to domestic violence, Cory still finds it in his heart to think of others and defend them. Today, for the first time, I witnessed the shocking treatment which Cory received from Hoaxtead trolls. Some of you may find this disturbing.
My name is Cory Miller and I have cerebral palsy. My mother, Nancy, was a victim of domestic violence and was killed by her husband. I actually witnessed the whole ordeal in very close proximity. I moved to Illinois with my biological father and his girlfriend for 5 years. There I was a victim of child and neglect by my own family members. I'm back home in Indiana, and very proud to be. I research child abuse cases now, and I have been for 3 years, or so. I ran across a YouTube video of a little 8-year-old boy, Gabriel Dearman, making a police report against his biological father, Ricky Dearman, and the staff at Christ Church Primary School. Gabriel accounted numerous accounts of horrendous sexual abuse which were satanic in nature. Gabriel went to very gruesome detail about the abuse that he was receiving by a cult headed by his father Ricky. Gabriel indicated he could perform sexually at the age of 3. With that information, I then theorized that the child had precocious puberty. When a child has precocious puberty, they will have sexual characteristics as a post-pubescent individual. Gabriel described the act of ejaculation at just 8 years old. Gabriel claimed to have been rectal molested with different sizes of penis-shaped sex toys referred by the children as fake willies. In my personal opinion, the different sizes of the said toys is to slowly stretch the tissues on the walls of the rectum and or vagina to prevent excessive bleeding and ultimately from other people noticing. And Gabriel indicated that he was made to perform oral sex to the members of the cult, including 20 special children. Lisa and Gabriel both indicated they had been forced into participating with child sacrifices. The victims that were used in the ritual were required by the local child protective service of the unwanted and abused children, which was in exchange of money, drugs, sex, or something of that nature. Gabriel and Alisa indicated that the cult members all have unique tattoos on the genitals. I personally don't think that they could be lying, actually, seeing the physical evidence convicting the cult. I say the evidence actually gratifies the children's testimonies. The police department did not investigate the case well at all. The doctor that examined the children indicated her findings could prove the children's original testimony. Given the physical evidence, the police and the Child Protective Service took the children from their mother and gave them to their father. It goes without saying that was unethical and unmoral, to say the least, on the behalf of the Hampstead Police Department and the Child Protective Service. It's my opinion, being a former victim of child abuse, that these children are deceased. The children that were with Mr. Dearman at the eBay Business Awards were imposters. I give the children's mother, Ella Garava, my prayers, and the 18 other children my prayers and my apologies for humanity. I'm Cory Miller Hamby, and God bless you and your family.